Hey guys, what's up? Sasha here, and I'm so excited that you guys clicked on this video. In today's video, we are going to talk about me turning 27 and how I feel and what's been going on lately in my life. And yeah, more stuff like that. So if you're excited to watch, just keep watching. But make sure you guys subscribe and hit that bell so that you guys can be notified when I upload a new video. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Okay guys, just one more quick thing before I get started. So I am going to be doing Vlogmas. I haven't decided really on how I want to upload. I feel like I don't want to stress myself out too much. I want this to be fun and I want to keep up with it until, you know, Christmas Vlogmas. I want to do it. So I'm still figuring that out. But look forward to Vlogmas videos coming soon. I'm super excited. But yeah, today we're going to talk about how I feel about turning 27. Now, it's so crazy. I turned 27 on November 4th, this month, which is crazy. And this month is like almost over already. In a blink of an eye, I turned 27 and the month is almost over and I get married in like 3 months. I don't even know where the time is going, guys. This is crazy. But anyway, so 3 months, I get married, I turned 27. I don't know why turning 27 just kind of made me feel like an actual adult, like legit, like, girl, what are you doing? Gotta get your stuff together, which, according to Gary V, I still have like time like to dwell on what I wanna do like personally, but whatever. Anyways, 27, yeah, I don't know. I just, maybe because I turned 27 and I'm getting married and we're talking about more adult things like how to get a place and where you want to live and, you know, terms like that, which is crazy. And I'm pretty sure you'll see more of those kind of feelings and thoughts more in my Vlogmas. But I just wanted to give you guys like 5 things I realized before I turned 27 and when I turned 27. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get started. So some things I've come to understand about life, I have written down because I don't want to like forget them or like get off topic. So the first thing I think that is so important is personal growth. I've been really getting into personal growth within the last maybe year, pretty seriously, probably beginning of this year. My fiance is very, very big on personal growth. He is a part of a company that we both love and it really focuses on personal growth, which is an amazing thing for everyone. I think everyone should be trying to grow mentally, you know. Let's see, it's basically working on your mindset and how you view things, having a better eye at how you view things and perspective on how you view things. Basically like not letting certain things affect you that shouldn't affect you. Making better choices and lifestyle choices. It's very empowering. Every morning, I try to every morning, especially before I go to work, on my way to work, I listen to an audio that's very inspiring or motivational or like teaching that helps jumpstart my day. It makes me feel really good. So I recommend you guys listening to an audio once a day, twice a day, however many times a day, at least once a day to like help with that, and it'll help you look at things in a different picture. The second thing I learned is to surround myself with positive, good people. So, let's see. Surround yourself with positive people and delete negative people. So if you have somebody around you that is constantly negative all the time, do not be around that person all the time because eventually their negative energy is gonna rub off on you. I'm huge on energies. I feel like I can feel energies when I walk into the room. Like I can feel if that person's energy is not well, or this person's energy is awesome. But yeah, in the workspace, I want to say it's probably harder because you're with them a lot, but you're not with them. You're kind of with them a lot, but just try to block it out on your break. Listen to some positivity or just try to turn it around if you are around people in the negative at work or at school. If you're at school around negative people, I think it's easier at school to kind of get away from that. Like, don't be friends with them. I know it sounds simpler than it may seem, but don't be around the negativity. It's really not that great. And surround yourself with more positive than negative. A great positive energy that I have, or like people that I have, I consider is, I can't talk, guys. You'll learn this, and I'm gonna get better at it, promise. The more I talk, but being at my church, I attend church by the Glades, and it's amazing positive energy that I love. I crave it, so that's why I always go to my church. My church is amazing. It's fun. It's loving. It's a good learning environment. It's just all around amazing. So if you live in like South Florida, you can check out Church by the Glades. There's different campuses, you know, that you guys can check out. It's awesome. I'll have the link down below because they're amazing. I love that church so much. Third is, do not be afraid to speak up for yourself. I can be very quiet, very, like, extremely quiet. But I've learned to speak up when I need to. If you need to defend yourself, or if you feel like you want to speak up on something you don't necessarily agree with that may affect you or something like that, don't be afraid to speak up. It's never, like, I was brought up in a, like, Jamaican, Caribbean kind of household where you have to respect your elders. And yes, be respectful to people who are older than you. I do still believe in that. But also, just because they're older than you doesn't mean you can't say how you feel in a respective way. Did that make sense? So yeah, if you don't think something should go, or you don't feel comfortable doing something, speak up. Like, just don't sit there and do it and then end up wasting the time that you could have done something else that you like to do. So yeah. Number four, if something you don't want to do scares you, do it anyway. So this comes for me when I sing anywhere. I love singing. But that might be a different video I need to talk about. But I loved singing. I loved going on stage and singing, especially at my church. But it terrifies me. One, at church, because it's like kind of, you want to sing well. Obviously, you want to sing the notes right and things like that. But also at church, you're wanting to bring people to God and relax them and make them feel comfortable. And if you don't do a good job, then I feel like I'm not doing well, like I'm failing at that. But you know, you do your best, and the best is all anybody can ask for. So yeah, if something scares you, like that you're passionate about and that you really love, you should still do it, because in the end you'll be so proud of yourself and you'll love that you did do it. And then the last thing is, speak positive things always about yourself. Listen to audios, which I said in the beginning. Always speak positive things about yourself. If you keep claiming that you're fat, or you're not smart, or you're not pretty, or you'll never amount to anything, that's what you're going to be attracting to your life. I've been reading The Secret, which I need to finish it. I've been procrastinating, but it just says, speaking it into the universe, you're putting it out in the universe, and whatever you're speaking out into the universe, you're going to get back. So if you're speaking like that, obviously the universe is gonna listen and give you what you're wanting, obviously. But yeah, so don't speak negative, speak positive. It's still hard. I know it's really hard as a girl, personally myself, sometimes I do it. I look a hot mess today. I don't like how this looks. I look like this. Oh my gosh, I'm never gonna get that. But you have to kind of flip it, and I've been doing it better. As soon as I realize I'm speaking negative, I try to flip it and be like, no, Sasha, you look good today. Maybe not as good as yesterday, but hey, we're gonna get there. But no, speak positivity and speak into your life and over other people's life. Never speak negative on anybody. And yeah, that's a big thing. Don't do that. Listen to audios. So me and my fiance send each other back and forth audios, and sometimes I send them to my little Kiki, I said it like she's a puppy. She's not a puppy. She's like my little sister. I send her positive stuff because she likes to hear it. She's in high school, and it makes me really happy. But yeah, I'm really excited, and I'm nervous about being 27. I'm nervous and excited about getting married. I get married in 3 months. I get married in March 23rd, 2019. I'm going to be an amazing wife. It's just new and kind of like nerve-wracking a little bit, but it's exciting. I'm super excited. And yeah, you'll see more about those emotions, because there's a lot of them, especially while planning this wedding. So, every time I talk about, like, think about the wedding, I get like chills, because I'm just excited, and I kind of wanted to be here already, but then you'll see more of that. But anyways, I'm gonna stop talking because I don't want this to be super long. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoy this, and I really hope you're looking forward to more videos from me and Vlogmas. Thumbs it up. Leave comments down below what you guys would like to see about my wedding, or any questions about that, about the wedding, or how I feel about becoming a wife. Leave them down below in the comments because that's awesome. Give me some content to talk about. Content, baby, content. But yeah, comment below if you know where that's from. But yeah, so thank you guys so much. I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe if you like, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Later. Deuces.